Hello, it is Saturday, the 13th of June in 2020, and welcome to another trip report. This trip report will be about a local train that runs between Münster in Germany and Enschede in the Netherlands. This train runs every hour. There's also another train that runs between Enschede and Dortmund every hour. So from Enschede you find trains to Germany every half an hour. But I won't show you Enschede in this station. There will be another video where I will feature the railway station of Enschede. In this video I'll be showing you the station of Münster, Münster main station, Münster Hauptbahnhof first. After that I show you the trains that run on this route, and after that I will show you some views. As always, I hope you enjoy the video. Give me a thumbs up when you like this video. And when you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, please subscribe to my channel. And don't forget to hit the bell button. I want to convince as many people as possible to travel by train. So how bigger this channel is, the better it is. So likes and subscriptions are very welcome. Well, for now, let's roll the intro. Before we start this video, I want to say this video has been recorded during the COVID-19 pandemic, what means it was a lot more quiet than normal. You will see a lot of people wearing face masks and you will see some warning signs. But I also want this video to be helpful for you when you make this journey in a couple of years' time from now. So in the video I'll just act like there's nothing going on. I followed all the official guidelines and of course used some common sense. So avoid busy places, mind your hygiene, etc. Well, the normal things. Well, for now, let's go back to the video. This is the route for my train today, from Enschede to Münster. It's not a fast train and there is nothing big in between, so it won't stop at bigger stations. But it's a nice way to travel between Enschede and Münster. It's also way more environmental friendly, of course, than taking a car. But that's obvious when you take a train. There are 3 stops in the Netherlands, all other stops are in Germany. This is the railway station of Münster Westphalia. This is the main railway station. The first railway station was opened in 1848, but the current railway station has been opened in 2017. In front of the railway station you'll find a lot of bus stops. Information about departing buses is all clearly indicated at all bus stops. Because of its regional function, you'll also find lots of buses to smaller towns around Münster. Münster is a city for cyclists. And around the station you'll find lots of spaces to park your bike. This is more something you can expect at Dutch railway stations. So a lot of space to park your bike doesn't mean there's free space to park your bike. But there is more than what you just see here. In front of the railway station, right next to the taxi stand, you'll find a big underground parking garage for bikes. And of course, in Münster you also find e-steps. When you walk out of the railway station, you'll be in the city center within a couple of minutes. But we're not here to see any of this. At least I'm not making a video about that. So let's go into the railway station and find out what's there. The current railway station has been reopened in 2017. So it's pretty new in here. Everything is very bright and in the railway station you'll find lots of shops. Of course, you also find the DB Reisecentrum, which stands for Travel Center, and here you can buy train tickets. You can also buy train tickets at the vending machines and online, of course. Within the main hall, you'll find a lot of shops, fast food restaurants, supermarkets, restaurants, etc. You'll find 2 tunnels that will guide you to the railway tracks. I'll show you more of this in a bit. There is no first class lounge for first class passengers. Well, that's not that crazy because most trains that do stop here are regional trains. And the first class lounge is only for people traveling with specific tickets on long distance trains. So the number for passengers on those trains is just not high enough. Toilets can be found near the entrance of the most northern tunnel. Directions for what can be found where are clearly given throughout the railway station. The combination of a big city with more than 300,000 people and a modern station makes that you find lots of information throughout the station. When you leave the station via the main hall, you'll find lots of information about departing buses from here. Just like what I mentioned earlier, because of its local function, the bus is a pretty obvious way for connecting transportation from here, especially when you live in one of the smaller towns around Münster. In the main hall, you'll find a big screen with information about departing trains. Time to go to the platform via the main tunnel. Within the tunnel, you'll find some more shops, vending machines, photo booths, etc. All platforms are accessible by stairs, an elevator, and on the other side, you'll find an escalator and more stairs. At the platform, you'll find big screens with route information about departing trains. For long distance trains, the train composition can be found at those screens, but also at a special display at the platform. And this is my train for this route, at Alstom Coradia Lint. You'll find these trains all over Europe. These train types come as hydrogen fuel or as diesel models. Well, most trains are diesel models, and on this line all trains are diesel trains as well. As you can see, these trains are pretty small. Time to show the interior of these trains. This is a second class only train, and all chairs come in a 2x2 configuration, so two seats on both sides of the aisle. All chairs are facing each other. Near the toilet, you'll find a vending machine where you can buy tickets. Personally, I prefer to use digital tickets, so I just purchased my tickets in the DB app. Near the toilet, you'll find some space to park your bike, but since the toilet is also wheelchair accessible, this also means you can park a wheelchair here. These trains are not meant to travel on long distances and in dense urban areas, so these are typical commuter trains for less populated area. Within the train, you'll find LED screens near the entrances and the exits that will give information about the final destination, the next station, and also the date and time will be written here. At the other part of the train, you'll find something like a quiet zone, I guess, with this door in between. Although on this specific route there are no stops on request, you'll find some stop buttons. I guess these trains are also being used for some routes where you'll find stops on request. At most places in the train, you'll find overhead luggage racks. You won't find this all over the train. The toilets on these trains are pretty good, well, nothing special though. You can also turn this into a nursery space for babies, as you can see here. Garbage cans can be found between some chairs near the windows and also near the entrance and exit doors. For the rest, this train won't give you extras. There are no power plugs, no free Wi-Fi, but just a train that takes you from A to B. At the very front, the very back, and on the side of the train, you'll also find route information. For now, I'll show you some views from the train. The views will be from Enschede to Münster, because I actually did this trip the other way around. There will be another video soon where I will feature the railway station of Enschede. In most cases, it's not the fastest way to travel between Germany and the Netherlands with these trains. However, they will provide a direct connection, and these trains have a really local function, so they serve the smaller towns between Münster and Enschede. When you prefer a direct train between the Netherlands and Münster, this train might also be very handy. This is not a fast train, and the comfort level isn't that good as in other trains. However, it's not a bad train, and especially for the smaller towns between Enschede and Münster, this connection is very useful. I hope you like this video. When you like it, please give me a thumbs up. And when you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, please subscribe to my channel. And don't forget to hit the bell button. See you on my next video.